Mission the Light, May 23, 2018, Heavenly Messages, second part of Revelations of Jesus Christ, through Apostle John, the seal scrolls now are open, letter number 145, part 4 of 9. The Lord bent down and cut a bunch of grapes. He was holding it like a precious jewel in his hand. He took one grape and he tasted. He turned toward me and said, "Come, John, you too try the juicy grapes. This will be the nectar of my blessings. The angels will step on them, on all these grapes you see here, and divine wine they will make from this fruit, from these divine vineyards. With this very wine I will welcome all our children in the kingdom of heaven. I myself will bless them and I will commune them with this very wine. It will symbolize my blood. I taste the tasty fruit and the juice of them filled my mouth. My lips were wet from the sweet juice. I never have eaten more tasty grapes than this. They were crunchy and sweet and smell wonderful. I felt alive. I felt as I was 18 years old, young boy. I felt alive and serenity, peaceful. I felt so much love and joy. I was living and tasting eternal life, moments of eternal life. I lived the promised kingdom. The Lord saw my joy and he said, 'Yes, John, taste I'm gifting you of everlasting life. This life my children are waiting for, and this exactly life they will live, eternal life. One by one, I by myself will bless them and I will enter them into my paradise. I am going to show them everything. I will manifest to them all the hidden beauty, and finally I will be able to share it with them. Come, John, let's walk some more.' We walk and walk farther through the vineyards, who are still endless in front of our eyes. But suddenly, like a pressed button, and the image changed in front of me. Now, as far as I could see, I was in endless fields with baskets of many sizes, and inside the baskets were white tablecloths. On the tablecloths, there were embroidery on them around the edges with satin white thread, tiny flowers, who they look like jasmine. In the large baskets and on top of the tablecloths, I saw loaves of bread. I saw steam were coming forth from the hot loaves to drool for. The aroma of the fresh bread smells so good. I heard the Lord saying again, 'Come, John, taste from this bread that symbolized my body.' He took a yummy loaf of bread and he cut it in half. He began to eat and then he gave me a piece also. I tasted and I was mesmerized. So tasty bread I never had eaten before. The bread tasted sweet, but it didn't have any sugar in it. It was sweet because of the perfect ingredients. The Lord read my thoughts and he said, 'Yes, John, the dough was kneaded by me from my own hands. I put yeast from the hidden manna. The saved manna of the heaven from eons now became a yeast for our chosen children. I don't want nothing less in worth for them. All the rare and holy belongs to them. Symbolically, I will feed them bite by bite, when one by one I will place them in the eternal paradise. Bite by bite from this bread I will feed them. Angels will, with white garments, protecting all these baskets with bread. The angels were singing hymns and glorify God nonstop. The Lord was happy. All the plans of the Father Creator and Jesus were taking shape and form. Seems everything was ready. Seems all these things were waiting for us to arrive. Everything was ready, even the last details of the promises of God. I felt all this. I also felt that the Lord was going to show me many other things, more places of paradise. The preparations were done. Only we were missing from there. I felt that in very short time we are going to be residents of heaven. Citizens of heaven was our new title. Citizens of New Jerusalem and of the kingdom of the true God and our Father. Alleluia. Amen.